Hello students, myself Rashmi Yande, your science teacher. Students, our third lesson, that is life processes in living organisms part 2 is going. From this lesson we already discussed the concept of reproduction, types of reproduction. Reproduction occurs in unicellular organism and in multicellular organism. After that, structure of flower, reproduction in plants, in that double fertilization concept, these all points we discussed in last lecture, in that videos. Today we are going to start sexual reproduction in human being. In human being, the male is heterozygous because he carries the X and Y chromosomes, whereas female, she is homozygous, that is she carries the XX chromosomes. For understanding the concept of gamete formation, fertilization, first of all we have to understand the structure of reproductive system of male and female. So next point, it is human male reproductive system. Observe the diagram 3.16, male reproductive system of human. In that, male reproductive system of humans consists of testes, various ducts and glands. Testes, we know that it is a gland which is present in male, and that gland secretes the hormone testosterone. That hormone controls the secondary sexual characters in male. Various ducts. Ducts are nothing but the passage through which the secretion it passes. And glands. Glands also secrete their secretion hormones. Testes are present in scrotum outside the abdominal cavity. Scrotum, this is sac-like structure, it is inside that testes are present, and this part it is outside the abdominal cavity. Testes contain numerous seminiferous tubules. Look at here, this is a diagram of seminiferous tubules. Small tube-like structure is there. These are called as the seminiferous tubules. So number of seminiferous tubules are present, and germinal epithelium present in the tubules, in and they get divided by meiosis process to produces the sperms. Because we know that sperms, it is a germ cell, and production of or dividation of germ cell is occur through the meiosis process. Those sperms are sent forward through various tubules. Sequence of these tubules is as there is the formation of sperms into the testes. From that testes, there is a passing forward that sperms through these ducts. So what is the sequence of this passing area? From reed testes. Reed testes, that is the inside the testes, small pipes like structure as there. Vas efferens, epididymis, this is the epididymis. Vas deferens, this part, this tube like structure, it is called as the vas deferens. Ejaculatory duct and urinogenital duct. Ejaculatory duct, look at the diagram here, ejaculatory duct is there, and urinogenital duct, that means this part, it is called as the urinogenital duct. Why? Because through this part, urine and secretion from that testes, that both passes, the common passage is there, therefore it is called as the urinogenital duct. Okay, here you can observe urinary bladder is there, and these are the ureters. Above that, kidney structure is there. Yes, so in this way, these are the main parts of the male reproductive system. Seminal vesicles secrete their secretion in ejaculatory ducts, whereas prostate gland and Cowper's gland secrete their secretion in urinogenital duct. And for the mobility of sperms, a substance is necessary. That substance it is nothing but the secretion of all these glands. So combination of these sperms and secretion of gland, it is called as the semen. Semen is ejaculated out through the penis. Penis, it is the last part of male reproductive system through which these semen it get ejaculated. All the organs of male reproductive system are paired, except urinogenital duct, penis and scrotum. Now, next it is the structure and function of the human female reproductive system. Here diagram 3.17 indicates the female reproductive system. This system, it is present in abdominal cavity. All organs from the female reproductive system, they are present in abdominal cavity. Includes a pair of ovaries, a pair of oviducts, single uterus and a vagina. Okay, a pair of oviduct, this pipe structure is there, or tube like structure is there, which is called as the oviduct or fallopian tube. And after that, next part it is the uterus, and after that last part it is the vagina. Besides, a pair of bulbourethral gland is also present. Generally, every month an ovum is released in abdominal cavity alternately from each ovary. Two ovaries are there. Alternately from each ovary in each month, one ovum it gets released. Free end of oviduct is funnel-like and opening is present at the center of it. This structure, finger-like projection is there na? This is called as the funnel-like structure. Inside that, a opening is there, and whatever the ovum is formed, it gets passes through this opening via oviduct, fallopian tube towards the uterus. Oocytes enters the oviduct through that opening. Cilia are present on inner surface of oviduct. Inside the oviduct, a cilia. Cilia are nothing but the hair-like projection is there. Yes, so that cilia, they push forward that ovum to move forward. So this is the structure of human female reproductive system and formation of ovum. Now, next point related to this, it is the gamete formation. Both gametes, that is sperms and ovum, are formed by meiosis process. Sperms are produced in testes of men from beginning of maturation, that is the puberty stage, till death. Puberty stage, that is nothing but the maturation stage, and from the beginning of that puberty, inside the testes, sperms are produced. However, in case of women, at the time of birth, there are 2 to 4 million immature oocytes in the ovary of female fetus is present. Female fetus, that means when baby girl is there, when she grows inside her mother's uterus, in her mother's womb, at that time, already inside her body, 2 to 4 million immature oocytes are present. But maturation of that oocytes and release of these oocytes, it is starts from beginning of maturity up to the age of menopause. Age limitation is there, approximately 45 years of the age. Up to this, there is every month there is a releasing of the ovum is occur. Menopause is the stoppage of functioning of female reproductive system. That menopause, it is a stage in which all reproductive system functions, they get stopped. And the age of the menopause, it is about 45 to 50 years. Menopause kyun hota hai? Because whatever the hormones, estrogen, progesterone, luteinizing hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, these different hormones, they play very important role. Secretion of all these hormones which control the functions of female reproductive system, they either stop or become irregular, and that leads to the menopause situation in female. Here gamete formation is over. Now next stage, it is the fertilization. Fertilization, how it occurs? First of all, what is the meaning of fertilization? Formation of zygote by union of sperm and ovum, it is called as the fertilization. Fertilization is internal in human beings. It is the copulation, when there is a ejaculation of the sperm is occur, millions of sperms are there, but ovum is only single, it is only one. So from that million sperms, only one sperm it get fertilized with the ovum, and this process is occur in the oviduct. We know the oviduct. Oviduct, it is a tube-like structure which is also called as the fallopian tube, and inside at this point there is a fertilization is occur. From the age of puberty, that is the maturation age, up to the menopause, that an ovum is released every month from the ovary. That is, out of 2 to 4 million ova, approximately only 400 oocytes are released up to the age of menopause. Remaining oocytes undergo degeneration. Sex determination in human being, this part it get deducted under the 25% deduction portion. Just read out this. So these two parts it get deducted. Next part, it is the menstrual cycle, which is related to the female reproductive system. Female reproductive system undergoes some changes at puberty, and those changes repeat at the interval of every 28 to 30 days. These repetitive changes are called as the menstrual cycle. This is the definition. Menstrual cycle is a natural process controlled by four hormones. Those are follicle stimulating hormone, that is FSH, luteinizing hormone, LH, estrogen and progesterone. Step by step, please listen carefully. One of the several follicles in the ovary starts to develop along with the oocyte presenting. Ovary mein kya hai? Follicles. Kitne follicles hai? Many follicles are there. Ye kya karte hai? They develop the ovum, egg cell. Under the effect of follicle stimulating hormone. ये hormone क्या करता है? Follicle को stimulate करता है कि वो क्या करे? Egg cell produce करे. Second, this developing follicle secretes estrogen. Next step, endometrium of the uterus starts to develop or regenerate under the effect of estrogen. At the maturity age, first time ये cycle form होती है, तब ये endometrium wall, it is a layer, first cycle के time पे क्या होती है? Develop होती है. लेकिन उसके बाद में, when because each month this cycle is there, so in each month it get regenerate. Meanwhile, developing follicle completes its development, it bursts under the effect of luteinizing hormone and oocyte release. Here ovulation, this step is there. Through these follicles, ovum, egg cell get released. So this is the effect of luteinizing hormone. Under the effect of luteinizing hormone, whatever the, when ovum get developed, the follicle get rupture, and from that, that ovum is comes out. Remaining tissue of the burst follicles forms the corpus luteum. Yellowish color substance is there. Okay, corpus luteum, what is the function of this? It starts to secrete the progesterone hormone. Endometrial glands secrete their secretion under the effect of progesterone, and such a endometrium is ready for implantation of embryo. Now there are two options, either there is implantation is occur or rupture of that ovum it occur. अगर फर्टिलाइजेशन नहीं हुआ तो कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम जो क्या कर रहा है, प्रोजेस्टेरोन सीक्रेट कर रहा है, इम्प्लांटेशन के लिए एनवायरनमेंट तैयार कर रहा है, वो क्या हो जाता है, इनएक्टिव हो जाता है और इट गेट कन्वर्ट इनटू कॉर्पस एल्बिकन्स. ड्यू टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कॉर्पस एल्बिकन्स, सीक्रेशन ऑफ इस्ट्रोजन एंड प्रोजेस्टेरॉन स्टॉप्स कम्प्लीटली. ये जो हॉर्मोन्स है ये क्या करते हैं, प्रेगनेंसी को कंट्रोल करते हैं, मैनेज करते हैं. लेकिन अभी कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम का कन्वर्जन कॉर्पस अल्बिकन्स में हो गया क्योंकि फर्टिलाइजेशन हुआ ही नहीं. जो वॉल तैयार हो गई थी जो है, दे स्टार्ट्स टू डिजेनरेट, दे स्टार्ट्स टू ब्रेक ड्यू टू द एब्सेंस ऑफ दिस टू हॉर्मोन्स. एंड ड्यू टू दैट टिश्यू दे गेट ब्रेक, वॉल इट गेट ब्रेक, and that endometrium wall, that unfertilized ovum, it discarded out through the vagina. This continues with bleeding, which continues approximately for 5 days. This is called as the menstruation. If menstruation is occur, then pregnancy is not there, and if pregnancy is there, then menstruation will not occur. Okay, unless the oocyte is fertilized and embryo is implanted, this process is repeated every month, start to regenerate. Again, क्या हो जाएगा? Ovum get release. Again, secretion of follicle stimulating hormone, estrogen, progesterone and luteinizing hormone, they starts to active. Fertilization नहीं हुआ, again it get degenerate. And what happened if fertilization is occur? This cycle, it stop temporary. कब तक stop होती है? Till the parturation, that is the childbirth. Menstrual cycle is a natural process and the woman experiences severe pains during this period. Severe weakness is felt due to the heavy bleeding. There is higher possibility of infections too during this overall period. Due to all such reasons, there is need of rest along with special personal hygiene. In this period, personal hygiene is very important to improve our reproductive health. Okay. So in this way, there is a working of menstrual cycle. Remaining part, that is the reproduction and modern technology, we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.